I wanted to come back around and dip into the H.P. Lovecraft world with this not so much sequel as one would think, but a reimagined version of Cast a Deadly Spell that now takes place in the 1950s, where magic is advertised as everyday use and the government is now trying to put the kibosh on it.
What are you gonna do? Did you hear that? That guy's gonna put the kibosh on me, he's crazy!
Where even Hollywood is utilizing it to resurrect old talent to enhance new ideas.
What place is this?
Ah, oh, it's a real pleasure, Bill. Welcome to Hollywood.
And where Dennis Hopper has replaced Fred Ward as Harry Lovecraft, the private eye, who shies away from magic altogether.
But in my business, it's better just to work clean.
I'm talking about Witch Hunt from 1994. This HBO movie was directed by Taxi Driver screenwriter Paul Schrader, who has a wealth of varied films he's directed prior to this outing. One of my favorites is Mishima, A Life in Four Chapters, with an entirely new cast of characters except for
Hippolyta Lavoe Kropotkin,
who returned, now played by Sheryl Lee Ralph. Lovecraft is bagging philandering spouses as we open this caper, which brings us to the statuesque beauty of famed actress Kim Hudson.
You were in a bathtub full of bubbles, and you had your big toes stuck in a faucet?
Let's do it.
Played by Penelope Ann Miller.
The name of the picture.
She was meant for the noir screen.
I want to be seen.
We hang with her and Lovecraft as they take in one of her pictures at a drive-in, which is...
you're very good in this.
Just a lovely touch. She's looking to bag her slimy producer husband, Gottlieb, who's supposedly been playing hanky-panky with a new starlet that's moving in on Hudson's Walk of Fame.
This isn't the first time I've been fucked in a producer's office!
Lovecraft takes the gig and we're off to pretty standard connect-the-dot plot by Cast a Deadly Spell screenwriter Joseph Darty, who injects much more magic into this universe, expanding on his first film.
Events cling to objects, and Trudy is very good at hearing their memories.
Very, very good.
Senator Crockett, played by Eric Bogosian, who is hell-bent on banning magic, has eyes on using Hollywood as the example.
That's a little premature, isn't it?
The stake? You might say it's symbolic. Nice centerpiece for the rally. Of course, now that Congress has passed the capital punishment bill, well, then it could be something else, couldn't it?
This is all propelled even further when Hudson's husband, Gottlieb, is shrunken down to a 12-inch G.I. Joe size, only to become his very own chew toy to his twin canines. Lovecraft eventually finds himself at a cat house run by Vivian Dart.
I put a spell on you. Cause you're mine.
Who sets up lovely ladies with the Hollywood elites, using her powers of enchantment to change a gal's appearance that would best suit her for potential stardom, or what the clientele may request. Lovecraft's nemesis in this is the late, great Julian Sands, who plays the dead-eye character Finn Maka.
You could whip up some of that mojo hoodoo, conjure up a lightning bolt and strike me down. You want some incentive?
I wish there was only more of him on screen. He's so much fun to watch. Hopper as Lovecraft compared to Ward, there is no comparison.
Yeah.
As much as I love Dennis Hopper as an actor, he was not for this role. There were times he looked as bored, otherwise confused as I did watching this. With pacing at a crawl for the most of its 1 hour and 38 minute runtime, the film ultimately didn't know what it wanted to be. One minute, there are great Lynchian moments where Hopper came across like a burnt out Frank Booth from Blue Velvet, to just very TV movie of the week vibes. It didn't help having David Lynch's composer, Angelo Badalamenti, scoring the film. It just caused me more to want Lynch to direct. Even though this may not land on all fours compared to Cast a Deadly Spell, for Lovecraft fans especially, I found a lot to like regardless of its shortcomings. So, if you enjoy magic, private detectives, and a flashback to the days of old Hollywood pictures, then this eye-popping movie might just be for you. Until next time.
Sorry.
I'm not sure I know what you're talking about, Fred.
So click links below to be notified. Many thanks for the support, and Hail Cthulhu!